Hi friends, I'm back again. This is Roop Lakhani and I'm a tarot card reader, numerologist, mindset healer and consciousness coach. Today's date is 29th May 2021. That adds up to 2 plus 9, 11 and then 5, so 16 and then again 5, 21. It is the 21 in the tarot card. It is the number of world. And if I have to total to single digit 3, then it is coming to Empress. So it is saying that today's date is very, very good when it's compared to all your dreams will be fulfilled and all your task needs completion and feeling of fulfillment. And that's how you'll feel more and more abundant. And Empress card is also saying that you need to really work with abundance feeling, and wherever you're getting stopped in this pandemic times, you really make sure that you have been fed well and you have been taken care of. So just ask for the blessings of more and more and remain in gratitude. So let us start with the Aries, the fiery sign Aries, who are very optimistic and enthusiastic. What cards have to tell about you? So it is saying that there are certain changes going to happen, and it's not going to be a superficial changes. It's going to be a very transitional, transformational changes. So make sure those radical changes, you have contributed or involved some sort of habits which are not serving you. You have given an end to it. And yes, the next cycle will bring you a lot of success, positivity, and maybe the experience would be a bit painful, but you will be able to see that how this changes will take you towards your better growth, positivity, progress and more. So make sure that you have incorporated some changes which are not the superficial changes but the more detailed changes. And we are going to see one more reading for you, and that's empowerment reading, and that's going to be empowering you what you need to do. So let's see what is that card for you. Aries, the card is very beautiful. It's saying that the instincts and the inspirations are coming to renew your energy. So follow your gut feeling, inner voice, instincts, hunches, inspiration, whatever you are getting, follow that. Alright, wonderful. So let's go to the next sign, that is Taurus. Taurus are earth signs and they are very reliable, patient, practical people. And the card for you is that you are striking balance to whatever you are doing, may it be multitasking, may it be two situation, or may it be whatever, and you are blessed with that. Why? Because you are putting all your efforts to juggle out all those multitasking situation, and you are giving your best, and you are also harmonizing all that towards your desired reality, and you are going to see the lot of growth, progress and prosperity for you. So all the best you all Taurus people, and let us see what is the empowerment card trying to tell you. Wonderful. So the empowerment card for you Taurus people is saying that you have your secret for your growth. So find that secret inside you. Open yourself to all the possibilities. Say yes to abundance, say yes to prosperity, say yes to progress, say yes to positivity, and you will be there. Fantastic. So let's see for the third sign, that's Gemini, and that's me. I am a Gemini, and Geminis are very, very social and gentle and affectionate people. So whenever you are finding yourself in the situations where people are very cooperative to you, very warm to you, you are the most smiling person and you give your heart out to them. And in case if you are single and you want to mingle, maybe a new relationship is coming very soon and you will have some sort of romantic affair. And yes, if you are going to make some choices, make sure your choices are made towards your better growth and towards your passionate life. Yeah, so all the best to you Geminis. And the empowerment card for you Geminis, who are very, 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 very airy sign, means very, very powerful sign for you all, the messages achieve and feel secured, safe and abundant. So be with that and all the best. So let's see for the next sign, Cancerian. Cancerians are watery signs And the watery signs, Cancerians are very, very imaginative, intuitive, loyal people. And the card for you is that you have achieved lot of material comfort, lot of financial security, and a sense of inner peace within yourself. Whatever responsibilities you are dealing right now and you have been doing up till now is fantastic with your self-control approach. So just enjoy the relationship, enjoy the environment. Everything is supportive to you. All the best, Cancerians. You are having a very great month, that is June month for you. So just enjoy. And the empowerment message for you, Cancerian, it's time for you to have harmony and balance with whatever your inner and outer nature. Make sure that at the inner self, you are in harmony with your own self, and you are outwardly also with everyone around you in the most harmonious, and that's how you will be able to feel great in your life. Let's see what is the Leo fiery sign June month is going to be for you all. You all are very creative and cheerful, humorous people, and the card is also saying that you have an urge for expansion. You may get some good news regarding some child coming in, or some sort of old friend coming to you, and your life coming to a very, very great feelings of how you to feel through those past memories or past contacts. And start achieving your goals, whatever you have in your mind, monthly goal, 3-monthly goal, 1-yearly goal, and you'll see how well you are feeling in your world. And let's see what is the empowerment card for you all, guys. Okay, Leos, the empowerment card is saying that you follow your instinct, your inner voice, your hunches, your that inner voice, what is it trying to say, and you will get all the clarity of thought, what you need to understand for your any future or confusions ahead. Yeah, so all the best, guys. And now we are going to the Virgo. What's your June month going to be like? You all are very loyal and analytical, and the card is also saying that you have worked enough, you have got your own wisdom, and you have patience through the passage of time. So what are you doing now? You have already stood tall in all the difficulties and challenges. Find peace and contentment within yourself, and you have your own spiritual quest to what you want to have. That spiritual quest only will come when you will have a deeper connection with yourself, right? So Virgos, take this empowerment card reading and empower yourself. And the card is saying that do your soul searching. Wow, what a lovely card you all have got. So do soul searching to discover what you truly want and how your choices can lead you towards more contentment, and rule out all those things which is not giving you the contentment. So Virgo people, all the best. Now comes to Libra, the Aries sign, the social sign, and the most cooperative sign. Let's see what the card is trying to tell you. Wow, and it's saying that you will be able to see how your work is progressive and how you're going to be balancing amidst all those situations which are taking you off the Libran scale, and that relationship or maybe the finances, you know, it will shake you up from inside, and you may feel a sense to again balance out. So you are capable, and that's how you will be doing it more and more. And yes, you can be uniting two different contradictory situations to make sure that how it works powerfully for you all. Yeah, so all the best, Librans. Give your best and give your best adaptability and diplomatic skills to achieve whatever you have to balance your situations. And the empowerment card for you is wherever you have got some hurt or emotional pains, make sure you heal them. Acknowledge and heal them, and that's how you will be able to see yourself moving on and feeling more positive. So make sure that all your hurts have gone on the way. Yeah, the next sign is Scorpion, and the Scorpions are very resourceful and passionate people. So let's see what is the card saying for you all. It is saying that there can be some sort of a very sudden events coming in your life make sure you do not get upset or devastated with it. Make sure that you have handled all your situation with lot of resilience and calm and patient approach, and yes, you're going to have a super good things coming up in your coming 1 year's time. So get yourself ready for the new chapters and new things coming up in your life. And let us see, Scorpions, what is the empowerment card going to be telling for you? Is that the strength? You have lot of inner strength. What are you not using it for yourself? You should use your wisdom, courage and inner strength to make sure that you overcome all your obstacles. Fantastic, Scorpions. Now we go to Sagittarius, and Sagittarius are the most fiery sign, who are very generous, kind-hearted and idealistic. And the card for you is that you have expert knowledge and so much of research and so much of concrete results in your life that you just need to appreciate you and what you have come up all the way. You also need to appreciate a lot of people around you who has cooperated and helped you, and you and your confidence can keep having more and more to get more work, more support and more cooperation from the people around you. May it be work, may it be family. Enjoy whatever you are doing, and make sure that you are not getting stopped whatever challenges you may be having it right now. Let us see the empowerment card for you all. It's saying that you dwell a lot into your deeper belief, and make sure that you are connected with your emotional world and you are having a greater relationship with your own self. Why? Because once you have a inner harmony, you will see everywhere people also harmonious to you. So fantastic, Sagittarius. Now we go to Capricorn. Again, that earth sign who's the most responsible and most dedicated, disciplined sign. And the card for you is saying that you are on certain type of journey, maybe more of mental journey of self-development. Maybe you've gone through some sort of health challenges, or maybe you've gone through more of agony in your mental health, but you are discovering your true self in this process. So just enjoy the journey and don't look for destination. Destiny is trying to connect with you, and destiny is also trying to connect with your hardworking efforts. So don't think anything negative, and yes, go ahead and have lot of interest into positivity and positive things what you can attract to. So the card for you is empowerment card is saying that reanalyze, introspect, reflect and rethink all what you have to do in your inner world, and you will see a new life outside and a new world outside which is more welcoming you. Great. So now we go to Aquarius, the most progressive original sun sign. The card is saying that you have been lot of imaginative, careful, loving people in your life, and yes, you are also hardworking and responsible. So make sure that you combine both and reach your practical finances or whatever you're doing, say education or any other aspects, and make sure that enthusiasm is brought into your life so that you feel more positive and more progressive. And the empowerment card for you is that you are very, very intellectual, so use your sharp intellect to cut through any confusion or illusions and make sure you have progressed. All the best, Aquarians. And the last sign we are coming to is Pisces, the most compassionate and intuitive sign. For you, the card is saying that it's time for change. Perhaps you need to be more adventurous and less conservative. Maybe you've gone through a lot of difficulties in this last month, and maybe now you are ready to move forward with complete positivity, gregarious, intelligent nature of yours. So keep following your heart and keep doing your hard work, and make sure that you follow your intuition, which you are very good at. And the empowerment card for you all, guys, is there is lot of enthusiasm and exuberance, success and material wealth coming up to break the darkness of your life. So don't get discouraged and disappointed with whatever has happened in the past 1 month or past few years. just remain positive, guys. Okay, so I think I have done my part. Now it is your part to follow the empowerment and take the positive message. All the best. Love you all. See you in the June month on my birthday, maybe around sometime, for another prediction. Bye.